Hi there. In today's video, I am revisiting Hoover Dam and I take a look at the water level. But first, let's roll the intro. Back in 2013, I visited Hoover Dam like millions of other tourists have done through the years. I took some pictures and I recorded some video. I did, however, not go on one of the tours, and since then I have just been driving past the dam a few times. So I figured it was about time I went back. I had a few things on my list that I wanted to do. I wanted to take some pictures and video. I wanted to go on a tour and I wanted to check out the water level compared to 2013. Perhaps take a bit of video here so I could compare it from then to now. I arrived early in the morning and spent some time shooting some footage and taking some pictures that you might have seen in some of my other videos posted this year. I didn't quite get the angles I hoped for, but I think it turned out okay anyway. As the parking spaces began to fill up with other tourists, I went to the ticket office to get a ticket for a tour and discovered that I should have done that as the first thing when I arrived. They have a short tour and then a longer one, and I would have liked to be on the long tour, but I would have to wait about half a day because they were filled up. So if I have a tip for you, it should be if you want to go on a long tour, get there in the morning when they open and get your ticket as the first thing, because you cannot book them in advance. With the two first items out of the way, it was time to check out the water level. Unless you've been living under a rock, you've probably heard about the drought in California. So I was wondering if it had any impact on the water levels in Lake Mead. I know I could just look it up on the internet, but where's the fun in that? So I tried to recreate the same shots as last time to compare them, and as you can see here, there's quite a long way up to the spillways. To the left you can see my shots from 2013, and to the right my latest from 2016, taken in late March. By June, the water level fell a bit further down to the first threshold where they declare a level 1 water shortage. This means that Arizona as well as Nevada can expect to see cuts in water supplies. The spillways have only been used two times. The last time was in 1983, and the year after, the generators produced the most amount of power they ever have, 10.3 terawatt hours. In 2015, by comparison, they have only produced 3.6 terawatt hours. According to some people, if they had enough water, they could produce, in theory, 18 terawatt hours per year. But because of the lack of water, the dam mostly provide power these days during peak demand hours. Hydroelectric power plants are really good at dealing with peak power demands, because unlike traditional power plants, they can quickly ramp up production. If you're running a coal-fired or a nuclear-powered power plant, it takes time to warm up and cool down, because basically what they are doing are they are boiling water to use in turbines. With the hydroelectric power plant, it's turning on the tap and adjusting the phases to the grid, and you're up and running. Alrighty then, this is all for now. If you want to see more videos of mine like this, click on the image in the lower right corner. If you're thinking to yourself, do I feel lucky? You can always click in the lower left corner to see how lucky you are. And of course, don't forget to click in the upper right corner to subscribe. Until next time, have fun on the interwebs.